Hi, I wanted to put together a really quick video to show you how to make a texture for Kerkythea, a 3D rendering program. This is not going to be the best video. It's more for me, actually, so that I can remember how to do the process. So it's just the basics. Let's grab a texture. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to grab a texture right out of Kerkythea and then mimic it. So let's go to material editors. I've got some libraries set up, and I'll just pick a wood plank. Let's pick wood plank seamless 3. I actually just picked seamless 2. So here's a pattern, and you can get patterns all over the internet. You can make your own. There's lots of tutorials about how to do that. So I want to make this a texture in Kerkythea. So I need a bump map and a normal map. Alright, so first thing I like to do is I like to sharpen it a little bit, so I'm going to enhance it. And I'm using GIMP, a free Photoshop clone, to do all of this sort of thing. I'm just going to increase the sharpness a little bit. Then I'm going to desaturate it. So I'm going to go to, you can tell I'm not the greatest at this, grayscale. And then I'm going to go to filters and enhance, no, which one do I want? Artistic. I'm going to go to photocopy. And so this is how I'm going to make my bump map, right? It's a sort of a grayscale image that helps give a little depth to the image. So I'm going to mask the render. And this is where you have to play with it. The darker, the bigger bumps I think you're supposed to get. But anyways, that looks pretty good. It's sharp. Let's go full sharpness. Pretty simple, right? There's a bump map. So I'll just save that as, let's call it plank 2 bump. All right. Save it, yes, please. All right, so I'll undo everything. And there's my original image. I better just save this because I made a copy. So I'll call it plank 2 tall bridge guy. Let's save that. All right, now I'm back at the beginning and I need a normal map. So again, I'm going to use a filter and I'm going to enhance it by sharpening it up just a little bit. Okay. And I'm going to go to my filters. Now, you can go to GIMP and they have a free filter or plugin that you can get that'll do a normal map. It also has a bump map, but I didn't like it, so I just did it the old-fashioned way. So here's a normal map, and it sort of shows you what's going on. I picked the Sobel 3x3, and it gives a lot of texture in there. Scale 1, the minimum Z, you're going to have to play around with that, but I'm just going to put it at 0.5, and I'm going to go OK, and there's my normal map. And I'm going to save that as tall bridge guy, normal map. And obviously all these settings you can play with and do different things with. I just want to go through the different steps. So there's my normal map. So, okay, let's get rid of this. Open up Google SketchUp. Get rid of the young lady. Put a little cube. All right, it's my cube. So I want to just put some lines in it so I can show the differences between textures. And here. I'll fill it up, and then I'm going to pick another color, just like that. And so SketchUp, you can get a plugin that'll extrude sounds weird, export an XML file for Kerkythea. So let's do that, export the model, and we'll call it cube tall bridge guy. Have I said tall bridge guy enough? Probably not, huh? So I have it set so Kerkythea comes up. And if you do a quick render of it, let's do a quick render of it. Medium, use all my cores, go to 640. Obvious, pretty boring, it's just the colors that I have. So Kerkythea comes with libraries, or you can import and install libraries from the website. So I'm going to add a material. And I got some materials, but the one I was working with wood planks, and it was plank 2, right? The one I'm trying to mimic. And if I did a quick render of that, not so good. So not the fastest laptop in the world, so you have to just give it a second. But it's there, it's just that the size is wrong. So we'll just stop this one, and we can change the size. Let's edit the material, click on the diffuse channel, click down here on the pattern, go to scale, and I think it has to be really small, so 0.01, 0.01. But then I also have to click on the texture up here. Go down here, this is that bump map, 0.01, 0.01. Go to the texture, which is the normal map, 0.01, 0.01. Getting a little repetitive. Apply, and now I can try and render it and see if I did a better job. And I'm not rendering it on very high resolution because I want to do it fast, and you can see the planks are coming up. Right? Not bad. So let's get out of that before it takes forever in this video. And let's go to my other color, turn that one off, and edit material. Well, I don't have a material, so I'm going to go to this one, get rid of that. Add a bitmap, and I have to go to the folder, and what did I call it? Planks, tall bridge guy, all right. And while I'm here, I might as well get the scale the same as the other one, 0.01, 0.01. And I'm gonna go over to my texture and add a bump map, browse, what did I call it? Tall, there's the normal map, scene, 2BG. Did I not save it? I'm pretty sure I did. Modified date. There's the normal. Planks 2, I guess I just called it a bump. There it is. Might as well have changed the scale to 0.01. 0.01. Down here, the normal map, I'll add a texture. Browse, and this time I think I gave it a name, normal map. Might as well just change the scale while I'm at it. Go apply, close this editor, and now let's go a little bit better path tracing and see what we get. I guess I should be putting some music on this stage so you don't get bored. But you can see the rendering. It's coming along pretty well, and my rendering matches the rendering that came with the program or an installed library. So I think it's a pretty good system. It's pretty fast. Don't go crazy in the light. Change the light just a little bit. But it's a pretty good looking system. It's still rendering. I'm only up to 9 out of 10,000, so depending how long you want to render it. Let's close it down, stop the render. Go a little closer. It doesn't look too bad. It does look like it's real wood. Obviously, it's got to run for a little while, but not too bad. So that's really simple, and probably everybody knows how to do this but me, but so I thought I'd make a video and give me something to remember this system by. So hopefully it helps you too.